He was named after his father, Kimoi Arab Chebi, a clan herdsman whose ancestors had migrated from the Nile Valley, settled in the Tugen Hills in the 19th century to avoid the skirmishes with the Maasai's. Moi was the fifth child of Kabon, Chebi's first wife. He was named Toroitich, which means welcome home, the cattle. His father died when he was 4 years old, leaving his elder brother Tuitoek to play the guardian role. It was Tuitoek who influenced him to go to school. He started school in 1934 at African Inland Mission School at Kabartonjo, and in October 20th, 1936, he was baptized as Daniel and transferred to African Inland Mission at Kapsabet, and then later went to the Government African School at Kapsabet. In 45, he was selected to join Alliance High School, but he was denied admission by the colonial administration. Instead, he was asked to enroll as a teacher training college, and on completion of his course, he was posted as a teacher at Kabarnet, where he studied privately and passed his London matriculation examinations. He was promoted to the rank of P2 in 1949 after attending a brief course at Kagumo College. He was later transferred to Tambach Government African School as a teacher trainer. Moi married Lena Bomet in 1950. Their union was blessed with 8 children, namely Jennifer Moi, Jonathan Moi. Jonathan passed on last year, and then me, Raymond Kipruto Moi, then Mr. John Mark Moi, then Philip Moi, then Gideon Moi, and lastly, June Moi. And he is also blessed with 21 grandchildren. And then someone puts a figure here for his great-grandchildren. But I don't want to say this figure, because who knows about great-grandchildren? Well, nani anaweza kujua hiyo? Eh? Hapana. Itakuwa mimi nasema uongo. So, and in that same year, he attended a course at Jean School, Kabete, and was subsequently posted to Government African School, Kabarnet, where he taught teachers up to 1955, when he joined politics. His entry into politics followed a meeting with a group of freedom fighters under the command of Brigadier Daniel Njuguna, who had visited him in June 1955. And in October 55, the Electoral College selected Moi from a list of 8 nominated candidates to fill a vacancy left by Joseph Oletameno, who had resigned from the unofficial benches of the Legislative Council. As a member of the LegCo, he moved a motion demanding that African teachers be allowed to form their own association. This led to the formation and registration of Kenyan National Union of Teachers in 1957. And he worked alongside other leaders like Eliud Mathu, Ronald Ngala, Masinde Muliro in agitating for the release of Jomo Kenyatta from prison and greater African representation in the LegCo. In 1959, Moi led a group of leaders who visited Jomo Kenyatta in detention in Lodwa. He was also among the Kenyan delegation under the auspices of KADU, who attended the London Constitutional Talks of June 1960. And in 61, Moi was appointed parliamentary secretary in the Ministry of Education and later served in the Ministries of Education and Local Government. He served as Minister for Local Government at age 37. And as all conference chairman of KADU, Moi saw the intricacy of politics and opted for a united and nationalistic approach, leading to the dissolution of KADU in November 1964. In January 67, at 43 years of age, Jomo Kenyatta appointed him as his vice president following the resignation of Mr. Joseph Murumbi. Moi then became president following the death of Mzee Kenyatta on 22nd August 1978. He served as chairman of the Organization of African Unity for 2 consecutive terms in 81 and 82. He has also been involved in mediation between various conflicting sides in Uganda, in Congo, Somalia, Chad, Sudan, Mozambique, Ethiopia, Rwanda, and Burundi, among others. He served as chairman of PTA between 1989 and 1990, served as COMESA chairman between 1999 and 2000, and the East Africa Cooperation between 1996 and 2002. And after a 24-year presidency, Moi handed over the reins of power to Mwai Kibaki in a peaceful transition that followed the National Rainbow Coalition's victory over KANU in the December 2002 general elections. The major test in his presidential tenure, of course, was in August 82, when there was an attempted coup when a detachment of Air Force soldiers attempted to overthrow the government. Since retirement, Moi largely resided in his Kabarak home in Nakuru County. Despite his international stature, Mzee Moi never lost touch with the ordinary people. The hallmark of his leadership was a personal commitment to uplifting the poor, the disadvantaged, and the old. His personal philosophy and belief in God defined his worldview and purpose in life. So we say farewell, Mzee. Thank you so much.